There are three quality of service classes: Guaranteed, Burstable, and Best Effort. Kubernetes uses quality of service classes to make decisions about scheduling and evicting pods. QoS class is assigned to pods by Kubernetes based on resource requests and limits definitions. At the end of the video, we're going to run some tests to see how the quality of service classes affects what pods will be evicted first if the system runs out of CPU or memory. To understand the quality of service classes, we need to clarify requests and limits of the pods first. Request is a resource that a container is guaranteed to get, and the limit is when a container is not allowed to use more than its resource. Let's start with Guaranteed class. For a pod to be given this class, requests and limits must be the same. In every situation, a pod will have the exact the same CPU and memory. When we create this pod, Kubernetes will update the status and mark QoS class as guaranteed. The Kubernetes scheduler manages guaranteed pods by ensuring that the sum of both memory and CPU requests for all containers is lower than the total CPU and memory of the node. These pods have the highest priority and they will not be killed until the system exceeds the resource limit. The next class is Burstable. Any pod that has a higher CPU or memory limit than the request will be marked as Burstable. You should use this quality of service class when the pod requires a range of CPU or memory usage. CPU and memory values can be between request and limit definitions. When the limit value is more than the request value, QoS class is Burstable. If there is no limit values, pods are Burstable as well. In this situation, the Kubernetes scheduler cannot ensure that burstable pods are deployed to nodes with enough resources. If there is no best effort class pods, these pods are killed before guaranteed class pods when they reach their limit. Finally, the pod is marked with best effort class when a pod has no memory or CPU request or limit definition. Because there is no limit definition, pods that are marked as best effort can only get the memory or CPU that a node has. When there is no limit or request value, QoS class is best effort. Best effort pods are not guaranteed to be managed on nodes that have enough resources for them, and they are able to use any amount of free resources on that node. This can lead to resource issues with other pods. These classes of pods have the lowest priority, and they will be killed first if the system has no memory. Now let's try to load test our system. We have three pods, one with guaranteed class, one with burstable, and best effort. Let's SSH to the Kubernetes node and check how much memory it has. We have almost 2 GB of memory. Now let's use the StressedNG Linux tool to stress test VM. You can simulate high memory usage. For example, use 2 GB. Let's run and see what's going to happen. Pods with burstable and best effort exited with error, but the pods with guaranteed class kept running without any issues. If you want more videos like this, subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.